that mourns in lonely heads, I'll hear until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come.
This is a message we have heard from him and proclaimed to you.
That God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was God.
And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord.
Come, let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us.
Come, all
Our acclamation for this Feast of the Incarnation is found on page 145 in your Book of Common Prayer. For unto us a child is born.
Unto us a son is given.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven, heaven, nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Let us our songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills, and plains repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. No more let sin and sorrows grow, nor thorns infest the ground. He comes to make his blessings flow, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. O God, you have caused this holy night to shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that we who have known the mystery of that light on earth may also enjoy him perfectly in heaven, where with you and the Holy Spirit he lives and reigns, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
Our first reading is from Isaiah 9, 1 through 7. But there will be no gloom for her who was in anguish. In the former time he brought into contempt the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali. But in the later time he has made glorious the way of the sea, the land beyond the Jordan, Galilee. Of the nations, the people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in a land of deep darkness, on them has the light shone. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as they are glad when they divide the spoil. For the yoke of his burden and the staff for his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For every boot of the tramping warrior in battle tumult, and every garment rolled in blood will be burned as fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end. On the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand and let's say together Psalm 96, which you'll find on page 395 in your Book of Common Prayer. We'll say this responsively. by the half verse. Page 395, Psalm 96. O sing unto the Lord a new song.
Sing unto the Lord all the whole earth.
Sing unto the Lord and praise his name.
Tell of his salvation from day to day.
Declare his honor to the nations.
And his wonders to all peoples.
For the Lord is great and highly to be praised.
He is more to be feared than all gods.
As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols.
But it is the Lord who made the heavens.
Glory and majesty are before him.
Power and honor in his sanctuary.
Ascribe unto the Lord, O you families of the peoples.
Ascribe unto the Lord worship and power.
Ascribe unto the Lord the honor due unto his name.
Bring offerings and come into his courts.
O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness.
Let the whole earth stand in awe of him.
Tell it out among the nations. The Lord is king.
It is he who made the world so firm that it cannot be moved. He shall judge the peoples righteously.
Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad.
Let the sea make a noise and all that is therein.
Let the field be joyful and all that is in it.
Then shall all the trees of the wood rejoice before the Lord.
Please be seated for the second.
A reading from Titus. For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people, training us to renounce ungodliness and worldly passions and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in the present age, waiting for our blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to redeem us from all lawlessness and to purify for himself a people for his own possession who are zealous for good works. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The stars in the sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle are lowing, the baby awakes. The little Lord Jesus, no crying. I love thee, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky, and stay by my cradle till morning is high.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be registered, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them and the glory of the Lord shone around them and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased. When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us. And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ. Be near me, Lord Jesus, I ask thee to stay close by me forever and guard me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in thy tender care and fit us for heaven to live.
Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from him who is, who was, and who is to come. Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, the ruler of the kings of the earth. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased. It is COVID Christmas 2020, and I think we all could use just a little bit of heavenly peace. My sister Martha texted me last week, and she and my other siblings, she texted us a little meme. I realize in my last sermon I said meme, and my kids ribbed me for it endlessly. I guess it's meme. But she texted me a little meme to myself and to my sisters, and it read this: Mary, exhausted, having just gotten Jesus to sleep, is approached by a young man who thinks to himself, what this girl needs is a drum solo. I think every parent, especially every mother of a newborn, can relate with the tension that makes this somewhat humorous. Oh my God, goodness, I just got baby Jesus to sleep, and the neighborhood shepherd boy shows up and he offers me a Neil Peart drum solo. Shall I play for him, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum? No! Can't you see what this yon virgin needs is heavenly peace? Can I get, please, just a little heavenly peace? Well, beyond the humor in this is also a good reminder that on the other side of heavenly hosts and angelic angels singing glory to God in the highest is the incarnational reality that the divine has come to us as one of us. God giggles. God gets tired. God needs sleep. God gets cold. God is hungry and he hurts. And then again, in this same baby, in the unrest of our earthly, in the unrest of our COVID reality, this God brings to the world also his divine reality of peace. Heavenly peace. Peace that only a God can give. God has become human. God formed as a human in Mary's womb. This is what we Christians believe. God delivered into the world through the pain and the mess of human labor and human delivery. God cried out in the cold with his mother. God hungered and was fed from his mother's breast. God needed to be burped. God needed to be cleaned up and changed. And God entered our world and he found out for himself exactly what we all already know to be true. That without the divine, there is no heavenly peace. Not for him, not for his mother, not for us. He soon learned our reality. War, political division, dishonesty, persecution, economic and food injustice, greed. There is no peace. There's poverty, crime, abuse of power, physical and sexual abuse, drug abuse, theft, murder. There is no peace. There's addiction, infidelity, divorce, brokenness, broken relationships, broken families, broken homes, broken lives, broken identities, broken dreams. But there is no peace. There's earthquake and hurricane, wildfires, volcanic eruptions, scorching heat and biting cold. There is disease and there is pain and there is famine. And yes, there is global pandemic. There seems to be no peace. Right now, I'm sitting here and not standing at the lectern to preach to you because there's no peace even in my own body. My own body is warring against me so much that up until a couple hours ago, I could barely move. And I know that there are many of you out there right now listening, that is your everyday existence. You have some ailment that maybe just this week I'm getting a glimpse of, that you deal with every single day. And I know you're asking, where is the peace? I think maybe many of us at the end of 2020, we're all asking that question, aren't we? What does it take for us to get just a little bit of heavenly peace? The feast of the incarnation that we celebrate tonight reminds us that in Christ, in this little needy baby who carries the divine, we do have the path to peace, even now. Real peace, lasting peace, holy peace. I know I use my yearly hikes in the local mountains often in my sermons, and that's because to me, these micro journeys amplify in a snapshot the path of our whole life. It's like a little 5-day, 10-day hike is just like a snapshot of life. There's the trials, the joys, the ups, the downs, the steady, grinding march, occasionally punctuated with both terror and glory. So every year I take a week or 10 days to vacation, to hike in the mountains, and I go fully knowing that I will struggle. I know that I will not sleep well. I know that there is inherent risk. And yes, I often ask myself, why in God's green earth do I do this? In many ways, I'm asking, where is the peace in this? The answer is always the same. I do it because of the promise. In the middle of the grind, the risk, the pain is the promise of fellowship, companionship, accomplishment, beauty, and joy summed up. It is the promise of life itself. It is the promise of glory that brings the peace. I've heard many moms say that after childbirth, after the 9 months of struggle, of sickness and soreness and discomfort, capped with potentially hours of labor and delivery, there's always, and then always the threat of death in that. Always, even today, there's always that. All those realities I hear from many moms fade to the back when the promise of life is realized in your arms. The joy of life. The incarnation reminds us that there is real life to be had even now, even on our journey fraught with peril, full of pain, of sadness and disappointment. There exists the hope in the promise of life that comes from the knowledge of God, most intimately in the incarnation of the Son of the world. Jesus comes into our world and he says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you, not as the world gives. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid." Baby Jesus comes into the world. "I came that you, that they may have life, and not just have life, but that you may have it abundantly." God seems to think that amidst the struggle and the pain and the realities of this existence, there is life now available to us in abundance. Jesus says, "I have said these things to you that in me you may have peace." In the world, Jesus says, you will have tribulation. We should not be surprised. There are no tricks. God is not saying, "Okay, I'm here. It's the incarnation. Heavenly peace from here on now." No, Jesus says, in the world you will have tribulation. But take heart. I have overcome the world. These readings from John 14 and 16, these are some of my favorite gospel readings. These are sometimes are the only truth spoken into my life that gets me out of bed some days. God has come to bring me peace even when I don't feel peace, and that the world seems to be closing in on me and everything seems chaotic, nobody's getting along. People around me are dying. People around me are sick. I can't pray for you well enough that you're getting out of your pain. But Jesus reminds us he's overcome the world. To know peace in this life is to know the promise, to know the incarnate word, to know Jesus. And this peace does not come by trying to bend him into what we want him to be. Peace comes from taking him as he has revealed himself to be and living in a way that pleases God. When the heavenly hosts announced the birth of Christ to the shepherds, it's interesting. Let's read this again. Do you pick up on this? That the peace offered in this case has a qualifier. The heavenly hosts are singing, verse 14 of Luke chapter 2. "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those whom he is pleased." Now, does this mean that God intends peace for only a limited few? I don't think so. But I think it does mean that those who live as to please God live then on his terms, and they then have his peace. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 7 says, "When a person's ways please the Lord, they make even their enemies to be at peace with them." Again, this idea of seeking the ways of the Lord brings his peace. To have peace offered to us when we adhere to peace, then we look like peace. We turn the other cheek. We seek forgiveness and we forgive. We honor our marriages and our commitments. We serve others. We live and we love generously. We stand for justice, for God's justice. And we are kind and full of his mercy and compassion. My late father, in all his inadequacies, I saw him live exactly this way. He truly strived to be a faithful man of peace, and in his last years, the reality of his humanity plagued him. He suffered terribly. His last days were spent unable to walk or to move on his own. He was confined to a room where he had no freedom. It's painful for me to remember that reality. But my only solace, my only peace, is that in the middle of all that struggle, I know that Dad possessed the knowledge of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ. And this gave Dad the peace he needed to endure until he received the crown of life promised to those who love God and serve him. This is really all of our reality. There is peace today for those who love God and follow his ways, even in the middle of our current journey. Every Sunday, almost without fail, at the end of our Eucharist celebration, we end the Eucharist with this blessing of peace. And it's a blessing of not only peace, but in it is embedded the incarnational reality that God is with us. The peace of God, which passes all understanding. Keep your hearts and your minds in the love and the knowledge of God and his incarnational reality, his Son, Jesus Christ. The peace of God which passes the limits of your human knowledge. The peace that tells you who you truly are, who reconciles your family, that satisfies the desires of your heart. The peace that brings you life. May it sustain you on your journey. May you so know the love of God that your life today may be so filled and sustained with the knowledge, with his knowledge, that you see and live into all his promises, even when the path is steep and the way is unclear. On this most holy night, the night that we celebrate the incarnation, if you're not feeling heavenly peace, may I pray with you right now? Let's pray. God, we yearn to hear your still small voice speaking to us through the din of all the things that clamor, all the things that distract, all the things that ail us, all the anxieties we hold. We listen and we strain for your still small voice of peace. God, many of us are out there tonight. We don't know where our next paycheck is coming from. We don't know when this pain will end. We don't know when this grief will turn again to joy. There's some of us who don't know the next time we may talk to somebody in person. God, thank you for sending your Son, Jesus, who knows us, who knows what it's like to experience all those things. And on this night that we celebrate your peace and your love tangibly coming into the world, God, in the power of your Holy Spirit, you promised that you would not leave us alone, but that you would come to us and meet us where we are, in the middle of pandemic, in the middle of our anxiousness, in the middle of our addictions, in the middle of our shortcomings, and yes, even in the middle of our joys. God, you are there. May we lean into you. May your Holy Spirit help us to lean into the knowledge of your reality in this world that needs your peace. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those whom he has pleased. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is visible and invisible. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God,
begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the church and for the world, saying, hear our prayer. For the peace of the whole world and for the well-being and unity of the people of God. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For Foley, our archbishop, and for Kevin, our bishop, and for all the clergy and people of our diocese and congregation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all those who proclaim the gospel at home and abroad, and for all who teach and disciple others, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters in Christ who are persecuted for their faith, Father, we pray for these individuals now, especially all the places in the world where they can't celebrate Christmas, mm-hmm. Lord, where they can't proclaim the gospel, where they are gathered in secret and in quiet. Lord, we pray that they would know that they are being stood by and stood with in prayer. Lord, we pray that you would empower them. Yes, Jesus. Father, that they could find solidarity in a Christ who suffers to spread the gospel, spread the truth.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, pour out your spirit. We pray for revival,
yes, Lord,
in these places. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For our nation, for those in authority, and for all in public service, especially Jay Inslee, our governor, Joe Biden, president-elect, and Donald Trump, our current president. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all those who are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity, Lord, we pray for the millions of people who do not have fresh water, Father, who don't have sanitation, Father, who have no dream of even having anything like a Christmas that we get to enjoy.
Yes, Jesus. Pray for those, Lord, who live in places of war.
Yes.
Where there is no peace,
yes,
truly no peace. Lord, we pray for those who are lonely.
Yes.
Those who are outcast. We thank you, Lord, that you came into the world for such as these, for us.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all those who have departed this life in the certain hope of the resurrection. Father, I pray for Michael Boone. Mm-hmm. In thanksgiving, let us pray. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Please add any additional petitions, thanksgivings, intercessions at this time.
Thank you, Lord, for this feast of the Incarnation. Thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to worship in this place and the ability to share that worship even if we have to do it online, but still your fellowship and your message of light and hope can still be shared. Thank you, God, for being in the midst of this church, for the people who serve here, for the opportunity to serve them. Thank you, Jesus, for the many blessings, this place and this time. Thank you for the ministry of Father Jack, and for his willingness to step in today to celebrate. Thank you for the joy of being his son-in-law, and the joy to serve with him today in this celebration. Thank you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, grant these our prayers for the sake of Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. By what we have done and by what we have left undone, we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who in his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all who sincerely repent and with true faith turn to him, mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the word of God to all who truly turn to him. Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, the end that all should not perish but have eternal life. The saying is trustworthy and deserving of full acceptance, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. And if anyone sinned, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. And he is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. And with that good and peaceful and comforting news, the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Greet each other with a sign of Christ's peace. Peace, Jack.
God's peace. God's peace.
God's peace. Peace, the Lord.
God's peace.
Peace with you. Peace with you. Well, Merry Christmas, everyone. So glad that you have joined us this feast of the Incarnation and this wonderful celebration. It's a little different here. We are at historic St. Paul's Church, which has to be one of the best Christmas churches in the world. Although, I will say, it's not quite as good this year because the church is not here with us. Well, some of the church is with us, but not all of the church that all of us would like to have here with us. I am grateful for the church that is here. Thank you. And on that note, as you know, thank you for your prayers for my back. I am getting better, but I asked my father-in-law at the last minute. Father Scott's on duty. You can be praying for Father Scott, and he's still recovering from his arm thing. But my father-in-law, Jack, is going to be our celebrant today. What a great joy that is, and makes it an extra special service for me, that's for sure. So thank you, Jack, for coming and being with us tonight. I don't think we have any other announcements. If you want to give this Christmas season, you may go to our website, and there's a give button right there, gatheringstpauls.org, or you can write a check to P.O. Box 143, Port Gamble, Washington, 98364. Thank you for coming and worshiping with us tonight. Yours, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. Yours is the kingdom, O Lord, and you are exalted as head above all. All things come from you, O Lord.
And of your own have we given you.
It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their hearts of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from hands of gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to
be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right, our duty and our joy always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you gave Jesus Christ, your only Son, to be born for us, who by the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, his mother, was made truly man, yet without the stain of sin, that we might be cleansed from sin and given the right to become your children. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself, and when we had sinned against you and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent your only Son, Jesus Christ, into the world for our salvation. By the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, he became flesh and dwelt among us. In obedience to your will, he stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself once for all, that by his suffering and death we might be saved. By his resurrection he broke the bonds of death, trampling hell and Satan under his feet. As our great high priest, he ascended to your right hand in glory, that we might come with confidence before the throne of grace. On the night before he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, Jesus took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, and we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your word and Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Sanctify us also that we may worthily receive this holy sacrament and be made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us with all your saints into the joy of your heavenly kingdom, where we shall see our Lord face to face. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
And therefore let us keep the feast. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Grant us your peace.
The gifts of God for the people of God.
This is Christ the King, whom share. thousands came to know him, the King of Kings, salvation brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you, the faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit bless you this day and unto the ages of ages. Amen.